the NumPy, the new, which is a numerical, it is an alternative of array. It's much, much, much powerful than array concept. Then the Plotlib, how to visualize it, the natural language processing, NLTK, game development, and Django framework. This is graphics user interface, tkinter. Another thing is not there. So some of the things are not there, like scikit. Okay, scikit, scipy, NumPy, there's another called scipy. They are the very useful thing to quickly develop the your program or applications. NumPy, what is basically NumPy is extremely very easy thing. It is basically you have to just include a library, import NumPy as np. NP, you can give it name by np or gp or ap, something like that. But the thing is that we now from next onwards in the program, we don't call NumPy, we call as np dot. So that is the reason it is giving np, and that is the standard convention all over the world, all of the programmers, that we always give the synonym, acronym or synonym of np. Okay, so and you can also be there import NumPy, you don't have to call as, then you have to always call, like here you have to call a x equal to NumPy dot array. So what is the advantage of creating an alias? It is called alias, and by so that you don't have to say NumPy, you have to say np. In Python, you see lots of examples like this. Please, very easy. I think it's much easier than C, Java and all. So that's it. So here I am declaring, it is very obvious. Here I am declaring you can call it array, two-dimensional array, and it will print out. Yeah, it will print out. And another thing, a matrix. Basically, this is a matrix. Yeah, definitely, is it I think, what the matrix? 3 by 2, three columns and three rows, two columns, 3 by 2. Yeah, and you can take the transpose because a NumPy, that is a great. Your C doesn't have how to calculate the transpose. So here you just say x dot t. T is a capital, and is a transpose function. Automatically the transpose will be given. Definitely, you know it is a 3 by 2. Your transpose should be 2 by 3. So then you can check that it is the transpose. That is great of NumPy. NumPy, you get lots of advantage. You can get the maximum value. You can sort it, the value, whenever your data structure classes, whatever the sort function, you can apply in NumPy with only the command sort. You can also name which sorting method to be used, like mass sort or quick sort, all these things. So another thing is, if you have your mathematics programming, your mathematics classes, you have probably have matrices. Your matrices, you have to calculate inverses, inverse of a matrix. You know all the inverse of the matrix can be only have if the determinant of the matrix is not zero. Not all matrix can be inverted. So all these things can be done. You can give a quickly command to give a value, a matrix, and inverse will be automatically come up. Then you probably know eigenvalues, where you put the lambda, minus lambda, to the diagonal elements, and you get the multiple values of the lambda, that is called eigenvalues. And another thing is eigenvectors. Eigenvector is very, very essential for your subsequent, if anyone's to come to machine learning, eigenvectors are such a vector. So whenever this vector is multiplied the same matrix, and the direction should be the same. That is the very great thing of the eigenvector. So any matrix, anything, but anything can be given in a matrix. Say I am doing a class, my picture, it basically a 1024 by 768 matrix, and it can have some eigenvectors and eigenvalues. And these eigenvalues are basically, you can compact your matrix, say maybe 90%. So the eigenfactors and eigenvectors are very essential for compression, decompression, and many image processing, computer vision, face detection, and everywhere you have to automatically inverse of a matrix. Inverse of a matrix is not so easy, you know, because you have to calculate the determinant value and all these things. But in Python, in NumPy, you can do all these things. Let's proceed. This is this code is available. This is not very essential. I put this command, this PIP, this, you know, particular Python command for installing libraries. some in your command shell also, and Google Colab also. It is gives the time factor. It is not essential right now, but I make it a habit. So you can ignore these two lines right now. So I just, you can check your, I think lots of times at the exclamation mark Python, it gives the version. And so here, what is the first command? So I have already told you, import NumPy as np, same. You can put it in your Python file. And then I last YouTube video, I always mentioned, always check the version number. That is always, you give a print with formatted string. What is the format string? If this is the string, would be automatically printed, and then the second bracket opening, second bracket close, like a set, like a dictionary or set, and you give the command format and np underscore underscore version underscore underscore. This is, what is this underscore underscore version? You probably heard whenever you have created a class, whenever you, that is already a method, that is called constructor method. In Python, we have underscore underscore init underscore. So this underscore underscore means it is a very private thing. Okay. So this np underscore underscore version is the, which gives the np version. And same is here, we need certain case matplotlib. It is very easy. And here also I give a small name mpl. And I also check the mpl version numbers. Another is plotting to display the things. So let's run it. What is happening? You just see this np version is coming from this, and np is this is the version 1.19.5. We'll mainly require these things today. We'll not start mpl. In our next class we'll go for matplotlib. So we try to do this right now. So here it is absolutely very easy. This is, I am creating an array of numbers with starting from 0 with increment 5 up to 30, excluding 30. Let's check. Here, I am np.arrange. Arrange is a keyword, is np. A is our, dynamic type of variable in Python. Python is in dynamic. What is basically is a list. Okay, this is a list. How do you know it's a list? Because it is a third bracket opening, third bracket end. And it starts from 0, and how many increments, what is the increment size? 5. 0, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. I am not including 30. So that is the command of arrange. Okay, that is print A. That is a print A. And then another command, that is np line space. This is line space command. Those who know MATLAB, this command is same. Range also there. Line space is bit difficult, different. What is line space is, it is, I have to, this is the first number, I need to get three numbers including 50. So see the difference between a range and line space. So B, I am creating one, and the end should be 15, and there should be total number should be 3, not it is increment. So the range is, the returned is 1850. That is the two thing np dot, this is np is no numpy, because I have called np as a numpy, and that's it. Let's see any other things. Like here you see np, here I'm calculating, I'm just, because I have a numpy as np, np a range 12, so it will give up to 11, not 12. And if I don't give increment, it will take increment default one. Functions has a good thing. Basically, if you don't give, it take the default value. So that I want to mention. This one is. And then you can reshape also. Say this is your y value. This is x value is coming, and you are x value. Then you want to reshape, like you reshape the matrix is 4x3. So you just give command np dot reshape. X is this, and your output will be this one. But right now I covered a numpy, and how to include numpy, import numpy as a np, because this is the beauty of this language, Python language, that it is very easy to do anything, very easy. I think you know, everybody should know what is between difference between overloading and overriding. Overriding is whenever you are rewriting your function which are coming from the base class or just previous class, that is overriding. And overloading is mean you are using the same name for different purpose within a same class. Okay, if you are taking a class and then whenever you are not giving the values, it will automatically take the default values. Yes, it's it seems the features is like little bit of overloading. So if you generate because function hiding that is called private function. Okay, the, I have if you, you have not seen my earlier video, my last video I have mentioned it. That is in any whenever you want to hide something, hiding means your encapsulation is better. Okay, you not only hide your variables because in your C, the problem is all variables is public variables, okay, even with the struct. But the great thing improved by C++, then you can have private variables. So that is great. So C++ is always a great language, but there are some issues of the basic inherent weakness of C is there in C++ to make it a compatible with C, like pointer. So pointer, I personally believe, a very risky thing for a language, but it can give havoc in your programming environment. So that is the reason Java, Python and all this doesn't have any pointer concept. That is one. And then your question is what is private function? Private function means it's a private function. That is, it can be called only by private public functions only. It is not available to outside functions. Private functions means if you want to put certain things, certain important things together, that's make it implemented so that I can call a repeated way, I make it as a function. That is the definition of function. Now, why I make it a public when I make it a private? Public means you can call the function from outside class also. You just call that function. You have to just class name and function name. But in the private function, you cannot call the class name and private function name. So, you want to hide. So, you put a private in front of it and what is the use of it? This private function use it that you can, it can be called by public function. You have anything you can reshape with this command, reshape command. And another thing is slicing. We are creating an array with np.array. This is the function call of np. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, the values I have already given. Then I want to print out only one, not zero. So what is the np.array zero? It is one. But whenever I see one, it will print two, excluding five. So this is zeroth, 1, 2, 3, 4. So it will 2, 3, 4, 5 will be printed. Let's check. See, it is print out 2, 3, 4, 5. Why? Because I wish to print out, this is a slicing. The first element should be one. The first element 1 means here the array, the first element 1 is 2. So that is the 2 is there. Okay, and I wish to print till 4, excluding 5. This means colon 5 means excluding 5. So we have 2, 3, 4, 5. That will be printed. Okay, so like this one, I have array 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I wish to print. It is a rather fifth element to the end. So what should this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So it will be from 5, 6, 7. So just count it again. This is 0th, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So fourth content is 5. So whenever the anything comes in the beginning, that should be included, and whenever anything after colon it is there, that should be excluded. That's a peculiarity there. So whenever it's a colon, nothing is there to the end of this thing, and whenever I give blank, that is for the beginning of this thing. That is the slicing operator in English, same thing. It is very peculiar. It is just here I see another slicing operator. Here you see print array -3:-1. So what is 0. What is -1? This is -1. -2. -3. So -3 should be 5 and -2 should be 6. So 5 and 6 should be printed. Okay. So that is very easy. I think you will do it and you can practice it. So I am creating an array. It's a two-dimensional array, 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 5. Array, it is automatically print out. It is a type of array, nothing great. And if you see the how to see the dimension, you just call array.nDimension. This is the np function. Automatically it is give the dimension is 2 because you have a two-dimensional array. You can command the shape of the array, array.shape. This is a np function. It will give the shape 2 by 3. Obviously it is a 2 by 3. It is a 2 by 3, 2 rows and 3 columns. So that is the shape is coming 2 by 3. Printing the array size, so how many number of elements are there, automatically looks 6. Creating an array from list with type float. You can command that my content should be float. Nothing like this. You just give a integer here, integer list, and then you overriding its float. So automatically the value will be 1 dot, 2 dot, 4 dot, 5 dot, 8 dot, 7 dot. Okay. Then creating table, creating array from tuple. You can create array from tuple. Actually, can you excuse me because obvious thing, the mic is on and this thing. Give me 2 minutes. I have to close the windows. Okay, there outside noise. Are you getting Panjali? Are you getting my voice?
Yes.
Yes, sir. If mic shuru hoye gache, shejon ja 2 minute amake janla gulo bondho korte hobe. Tale voice ashbe. No, এখন আর নেই, at least continue. Okay, hopefully it will not be there. Okay, okay. Next questions. Any questions you have? Anyone? Or if you want to go back, it is tougher, you can tell me. Today our target is matrix operation, create eigenvalues. Let's see, we quickly go through. So like I am initializing a NP zeros, this is a value with all 3 by 4 matrix with 0 values. See, all the contents should be 0. It is a 3 rows, 4 columns with 0. You know, this kind of matrix very useful, like I matrix, all diagonal elements 1, identity matrix, NP zeros are very useful for matrix operation. It is very essential, so it's to check it. Like, I mean, it's a complex type, like data type, complex type, and you can see the I am creating the value with data type constant value. 6 will be there, but it's 6 plus 0j. You know, the Python only supports imaginary numbers, and they are with the real part is 6.0 because I have told it is a complex and it is a imaginary part also 0. Because I have given the value 6. If I give the 6 plus 6j, then it will be different. I think it is very, very nice. Here it is very simple example. It is a random, it creates a random 2 by 2 matrix. So these all values are random values. Okay, this is a matrix is created now. Now you might say, I am to create a sequence of integers. Say here np dot, see here it will be more explained. What is the mean a range? A range means 0 to 30 with the steps of 5 excluding 30. Let's check. Yeah, great. So whenever you see the a range, it is 0, start from here and steps will be 5 excluding the last, this middle value. So here you see a sequence of array with steps of 5, 0, 5, 10, 15. This is same for your list command. Creating a sequence, same thing, in the range 0 to 5. This is, I am using the line space command. You know the what is the line space command? It is you wish to create 10 values between 0 to 5, including 5. That is difference, including 5. So 0 to 5, you want to create 10 values, including 5. This is the difference between a range and a line space. Now that is great. Then I am initializing a matrix. I initialize a matrix with 3 by 4, and I and then I reshape this matrix. It's initially 2 by 2 by 3, and then yes, it is a 3 by 4. It is a number, says 3 by 4, that is 12. It is 12 items are there, and here I did 2 by 2 by 3, here also 2 into 2, 4 into 3, so 12. So I am reshaping. So that is possible. Original array is this, and you just give the command new array dot reshape. The reshaping should be like this, it should be the output. Okay. So this you just have to practice, nothing it. Then it is another great example how to flat the load this. So you are initializing it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 with see here the third bracket and this thing, and you are just giving command flatten, it will automatically flatten. So if you just run it, your original array is like this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, the flattened array is like this. Now I quickly show you. See how to index this array, you initialize it with this value. This is your whatever you can slice it. This is very difficult. It's like colon 2 and colon colon 2. It does mean array with first two rows and alternate column 0 and 2. So I am just repeating here. This is the original matrix, and the first two rows, the first two rows with column 0 and 2. So what is the first two rows, column 0 and 2? Here is the first rows, column minus 1, and then is because it will not be there, 0, and the 4, this will be there, and it will be the 6. So this is your command. Just it says that print array with first two rows and alternate columns. So it will be, if you just check it, I'll give all the programs to you. If you just run it, you can understand it is nothing, not at all, it's tough. It is, if you forget, you just check it. This is called slicing operator. It behaves sometimes differently. Okay. Whenever you don't see anything else here, that means full row. Okay. So, that's it. Another thing we see it here. Now I go to directly, these are nothing but. Another very great thing of NumPy is like this one. Like if you have a create an np dot array 1, 2, 3, 4, that you will not get in C. Then add 1 to every element. Then you just add 1 to every element. You just give a command like this. Printing A plus 1. Just if you give A plus 1 command, like your matrix, 1 will be added to all elements. You just check it. So your original matrix is 1, 2, 3, 4. Now you just say A plus 1. Now 1 will be added to all items. So it will be 2, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that is the result. That is the result 2, 3, 4, 5. You can say subtract 3 from each element, multiply each element by 10, square each element, modify all. If you just run it, yes. If you just run it, you see here. So if you have, because if you have 1, 2, 3, 4, subtracting minus 3 will be minus 2, minus 2, because it is 3, 0, and 4 because of 1. Multiplying each element by 10, your original matrix is 1, 2, 3, 4, so 10, 20, 30, 40. Squaring each element because your original element 1, 2, 3, 4 is 1, 2 square 4, 3 square 9, 4 square 16. That's great. You are just giving the command like this. A minus 3, your matrix, your NumPy is item is A, you just give A minus 3, already you give A minus 3, here is A start 10 and A exponential 2, the squaring. So you get it. Now you get transpose of a matrix very easy. So here you just see, if you initialize a matrix with this value, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then original, then you just write A dot T. That in the first slide, you remember, PPT slide, we discussed this. It is a T is a function in a NumPy. So any matrix can be transposed by A dot T. So this is the original array, and in transpose of array, this is it. You just check it, 1, 2, 3 here, 1, 2, 3 here. So this is a transpose of this matrix. Then now it is the most beautiful thing is coming, another most beautiful, largest element. This is a matrix. Matrix, this is the, I am initializing. I can get the maximum value of the whole all items. I can get the maximum of the first row, minimum of the first row. I can get the maximum of column wise. Everything can be, functions is available in NumPy. See, maximum element of array, is largest element of array is just array dot max. Row wise maximum element, so row wise array max axis is equal to 1. Otherwise, you should be axis equal to 0 or don't give anything. Like here, I don't give anything. So here when I say axis 1, I say row wise maximum will be calculated. Minimum element of the array, I just say minimum. Axis 0. I can give it axis 0 or I may not. Okay. Sum of element element, array dot sum. Cumulative sum along each row, you will get it axis 1. So if you remember your matrix is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So, largest element is 9, definitely. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9. Largest element is 9. Row wise maximum, say 1, 2, 3, right hand column, 3, 6, 9. So, that's it. And column wise minimum, you remember the beginning point of each column. So, 1, 2, 3. First row itself, basically. Sum of all elements, sum 1 plus 2 plus 3 4 5 6 all comes to the 45, and cumulative sum along the each row, if it is a cumulative sum like first element 1, next element 2, that means it will be 2 plus 1 3, next element 3, 3 plus 3 6, so it will be like this. Okay, so this, all these things can be done by NumPy. Another thing is transpose. I have already given binary operators, multiply arrays, matrix multiplication, that is very easy here. You can do the matrix multiplication, like, yeah. So this is a, I am creating a matrix 1, 2, 3, 4 here. Another matrix B, 4, 3, 2, 1. I can array, I can sum A plus B, then the multiply A star B. This is matrix multiplication, multiple arrays, multiple dot operation. All these things come here. Array sum, you definitely see 1 plus 4, 5, 2 plus 3, 5, 3 plus 2, 5, 4 plus 1. So, array sum is 5, array multiplication, matrix multiplication, all this come by this simple operation. Now, I am calculating the inverse of a matrix. That is very useful to you. Like, inverse of a matrix, you are initializing with the matrix like this, you know inverse must be there only if the determinant is non-zero. So, it is automatically take care. You don't just have to do anything. You have to say some function is all of Nilian algorithm, then lin alloc dot inverse. So, you have to just write, if you have any matrix here, and you write print np dot linear algebra, linear algebra dot lin al dot inverse f a. This is the inverse of a matrix. I think that will be useful in your checking your maths program, and you can see it if you initialize with the identity matrix, inverse will be always identity matrix. You know, inverse of identity matrix will be the same. So it is the same identity matrix.